To start, you will put the frame on two supports, front and back. Take an inventory of the parts that are shipped with your kit. Now you will be ready to start the installation of your Auburn Junior. You will start with the front axle. The front axle will consist of a pin, cotter key, two washers, a nut, and a bolt. The front axle will be put between two brackets located on the frame. Using a pin and a cotter key and a bolt in the back of the axle to hold the axle into place. Now you are ready to put in the rack and pinion. Included with the rack and pinion are two spacers, four bolts, locker washers, and nuts. The rack and pinion is used to steer the front of the vehicle. This is placed in between the two sections of the frame with a spacer and four nuts. These are bolted from the inside on both sides of the frame. Once this is done, this is what it should look like. You are now ready to install your front spindles. The front spindles will consist of two long bolts and nuts, four tie rod ends with four nuts. There will be one bolt and nut for the middle of the tie rod end. Screw the tie rod ends into the tie rod shaft. You install your spacers into the spindles. And those are placed into position on the axle. Your long bolts will go through the spindle and lock nut in the bottom. This is done on both sides of the axle. You are now ready to install your tie rod ends. The tie rod ends will be placed on the spindle arm extension and bolted into position with the bolts and washers. The middle of your tie rod ends will be bolted into the rack and pinion assembly. They will hold your wheels in position. Next comes your steering column, which will consist of two long bolts, washer, lock washer, nuts, and two brass fittings. You are now ready to install your steering column. Your steering column will be bolted into place using a bolt, washers, and lock nuts. You are now ready to install your braces, which will support your steering column. Install it with a short bolt in the bottom and a long bolt on the top. Now your second shaft comes with an expansion pin, two brass fittings, a lock collar, and a spacer. You are ready to install your second shaft using a gear and expansion pin. Then put on a spacer. Put two brass fittings into the plate with four holes and put it in. Next, put on and tighten a collar. Attach the universal joint using another expansion pin. You are now ready to install this assembly into your frame. This is placed into position over the existing plate. You now bolt in using four bolts and lock washers. The nuts are already in place on the plate. Do not tighten the bolts yet. Now your steering wheel is assembled to the steering shaft using three bolts. This is now brought to the frame and placed through the steering column into the universal joint. Another expansion pin is put in at this time. Pick up the plate with the gear to straighten the steering wheel out. Place the gear into the rack and pinion so that it lines up. Then tighten up the bolts. You are now ready for the pedal assembly, which will consist of two large sprockets, bottom bracket set, four pedals, and two cranks. The sprockets will be put on the cranks. Next, put on one bearing on one side and a pedal on the other side. You are now ready to install the pedals to the frame. Using additional outside bearings and pedals, the detail instructions are included with the bottom bracket set. The back bearings consist of four right plates and four left plates. Assemble your bearings into the slot on the plate. The sprockets come with a freewheeling sprocket. It will be bolted into the main sprocket with four bolts. The brake support will be attached using two long bolts. Slide your brake into the slot of the brake support. These are now installed on the rear of your frame with the bearings outside and bolt it in with four bolts, lock nuts, and washers. The brake assembly is now put in place using two washers and a nut. Put your brake disc into position and slide the shafts through bearings and brake disc. The shaft on each side of the frame has to extend out 4 inches. Next, install your lock collars. and tighten the Allen screw. Next, install the cotter key through the brake disc and tighten the Allen screw over the keyway. Install your rear sprockets as shown and put in the cotter key and tighten the Allen screw over the cotter key. Next is the brake handle. Install the brake handle using a bolt, two spacer washers, and two nuts. Now you are ready to install the brake cable. The brake cable will be inserted on the rear brake. And attached to the brake handle on the front using two clamps. This spring will pull the handle back after use. A spring installed on the back brake handle using a self-tapping screw. The seat adjustment plates are not being used anymore. The seat brackets will be bolted from underneath using four bolts. The seats are then moved to the frame and bolted using four bolts per seat. Next, put the chain on the sprockets from the front to the back on both sides using a chain link. Next, put the front wheels on using a lock nut on each wheel. Also, install the rear wheels using a cotter key and lock nut. That completes your frame. Remove your supports and set the frame on the ground. Now you are ready for the body. The body gets a decal grill, plastic exhaust pipes, windshield, headlights and taillights. Then the body is installed to the frame using nuts and bolts. Congratulations! You are now ready to take your first ride in the Auburn Speedster Jr. Have fun with your whole family.